Hi, in this video, we'll be talking about Kubernetes volumes which are remote in nature. That means they live outside of the Kubernetes cluster. For example, NFS, cloud volumes, ClusterFS, and so on. Now, in this particular scenario, we have provisioned a NFS server outside of the Kubernetes cluster. So in the volume section of the pod spec, you can see we have used a volume plugin called NFS. And each volume plugin will have its own set of configurations. So for NFS, we have a server that we have to give and the path that is shared. And then inside the container, it's volume mount that is getting used for the container to use the volume. So in this scenario, you have NFS over here and container volume is using NFS, which is living outside of the Kubernetes cluster. Now we have already discussed MTDIR and the host path. So MTDIR is ephemeral and host path is using the node's disk. So if it's actually spinned up on another node, when the pod dies and spins up again, then it might not spin up on the same node. So there might be inconsistencies. But in this particular scenario, when you have mounted the NFS and when the pod is again spin up on a new node, then it will again mount the same NFS because that is living outside to the cluster, which is external to the cluster. So in this way, the data will be there even if the cluster goes down, and there won't be any inconsistencies if the pod also goes from one node to another due to eviction or any other reason. So these are the remote volumes where you have to know the details when you are using the volume plugin. So you need to know if you're using cloud volume, you need to know the details. And if you're using NFS, you need to know the server and the path. So if you are defining the pod spec, you should be knowing all about the volume spec as well. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.